Inefficiencies in power generation are something that most people don't really think about, but as an engineer, I can never forget them. Nuclear reactors, a source of 20% of the United States' energy power, is boil water and then send it through turbines, a process with many inefficiencies. Think about this. We take nuclear fission, supposedly our most advanced form of energy generation, and use it to heat water. Now, this process clocks in around 90% of fission, which is exceptionally good, but that means that 10% of the energy generated is simply lost due to inefficiencies. Now, your car, on the other hand, is much lower on this scale, around 40% of fission. This means that 60% of the energy generated in your car is lost due to heat, vibration, and other outlets. Now, you can harvest the wasted heat energy, but the technology is large and wouldn't fit on most cars. The vibrational, on the other hand, is something worth exploring. My research focuses on harvesting available vibrational energy and using it to generate usable electricity. I work with a new class of smart materials called magnetic shape memory alloys. This material actually remembers its shape in the presence of a magnet. So, in other words, if I shorten the material between my fingers and I put it close to a magnet, it will actually elongate back to its original length. This is due to tiny crystals inside the material that respond and try to align themselves with the field generated by the magnet. You can think of these crystals like little dominoes that flip up on end when they're close to a magnet. Now, because the crystals are shaped exactly like dominoes, with one side much bigger than the other side, when they do flip up, it actually causes the material to elongate in length. Now, you can topple these crystals back over, shrinking the material simply by pressing down on the top. Now, to what I do. I take this material and I wedge it in between two magnets. This causes everything to jump up on end, elongating the material. I then compress it back down, forcing the crystals to topple over. Because the material is still between the magnets when I let go of everything, all the crystals jump back up. This creates a fluctuation in the field between the magnets. According to Faraday's law of induction, if you have a changing magnetic field inside of a coil, this will actually generate electricity. So I put a coil around the magnetic smart material and use it to generate electricity. Now, this can be used anywhere there's vibrational energy or anywhere there's rapid, small, linear movements. Think about how much a bridge wobbles when a car drives over it, or how much a wooden floor shakes when you stand on it. Now, this material has been used for power harvesting purposes before, but we noticed that tilting the field around the material actually increased the output voltage. By simulating a tilted magnetic field, we've actually increased the output voltage by 500 to 1,000%. Last year, we created a self-powered road sensor that was installed here in Flagstaff, actually over on Beaver Street. What it did is it took the energy of cars driving over it and used that to power little tiny electronics inside the material. Now, in the coming years, energy usage is going to be a big issue in the coming years. So topics like this, including power generation and efficiency, are going to be a big topic in many facets of education. It's up to us to continue this discussion and help create more efficient and better ways to harvest available electricity.